This watch is a Junghans, and it's from Schramberg near the Black Forest. Something that's close to my heart because I'm passionate with cake. This particular piece is the Max Bill Automatic. And the Max Bill Automatic is interesting because Max Bill was a designer, an architect. He had a great prowess for design. He subscribed to the Bauhaus design movement, and this particular watch captures that beautifully. Max Bill's first work for Junghans was actually designing clocks, and they were incredibly legible, and that is very obvious when you look at this particular piece. The watch features Arabic numerals to indicate the hours, very, very crisp, clean lines, the hands, very easy to see. I often select watches, and that's what I've done today, which are very, very simple to interpret. A watch for me, you should be able to look at it within seconds, within moments of a second. It's easy to ascertain the prevailing time. Some watches are very unduly complicated, and you're looking and it's a bit confusing, and you're trying to discriminate between the hour and minute hand. There's no ambiguity with this, it's very clear. This is the hours, this is the minutes, this is the prevailing seconds, and this is the date. And it's those four indications that are very obvious on the dial. The date, in the customary position, 3 o'clock. The watch is quartz, so it does accord convenience. It's going to require a battery every so often. You're not going to be able to have to worry about winding it up. You're not going to have to worry about leaving it off your wrist for 3 weeks and then putting it back on again. It will still be running accurately. Quartz is also very accurate. I have to say, it is a little bit inert for me. I'm a fan of mechanical watches, but if you're going to have a quartz watch, this has got a lot to offer. It's very, very affordable. It's probably one of the most accessible watches that I've handled today. The pricing is in the three-figure category, and I think this particular one is literally only a few hundred pounds. So it is quite affordable. It's 38 millimeters, the case. It would particularly appeal to people with perhaps a diminutive wrist, a smaller wrist. One of the things that I sometimes talk to people about is put watches on your wrist and sample them. Never go off a picture. I have a website myself and I also write for magazines. And one of the things that people do is we always look at the picture and sort of make a decision saying, yes, that's the one for me, or no, it's not. There is no substitute for putting a watch on your wrist and sampling it, seeing what it's like in the flesh. And some watches that you may dismiss as not your taste, you actually put them on the wrist, they'll seduce you. And conversely, there's some watches which you've got your heart set on, and when they actually come to it, it's a bit of an anticlimax. This watch is very, very pretty. It's very, very good looking. I think actually would actually suit some ladies. I think the diameter at 38 millimeters would actually suit a feminine wrist very well, but it would also suit an average size gentleman. Not everybody's a little finer than myself. It's a lot to offer, and I say, I think this is certainly worth having a closer look at.